After being diagnosed with cancer, many people want to learn as much as they can about their cancer and turn to the internet to search for information. But how do you know if the information you find is trustworthy? If you need help identifying reliable information online, you can start by talking with your healthcare team.
Patients should feel comfortable bringing information to their doctor, and their doctor needs to take time and feel comfortable discussing it with them. I know that sometimes it feels like a burden to bring that information to the doctor because the visits are short and time is limited. However, as a physician, I want to know what my patients are seeing online. I want to know what their concerns are, what they're worried about.
In addition to talking with your healthcare team to help you identify whether the cancer information you have found online is reliable, it is important to always consider who runs the website, who creates the website's content, and who funds the website.
You want to make sure that you know where this information is coming from, and so that you can link it to credible research. There are so many claims out there that don't have the research to back it up.
There are many reliable resources available online, created specifically for people with cancer, their families, and their caregivers.
There are several great resources online to look for cancer information. One of them is going to be Cancer.net. There are a lot of patient-facing websites. And then for each cancer type, there are going to be specific resources. I would encourage patients to talk to their healthcare team at that initial consultation or at follow-up visits and say, I'm interested in reading more. Where are the resources for my particular cancer type that I should look for online?
For more information on how to identify reliable cancer information and how to spot misinformation online, visit Cancer.net, the patient education website of the American Society of Clinical Oncology that is vetted by cancer doctors.